Hello guys and welcome back. If you remember, in our last video I was making this part here also with the metal wire. The part with the metal wire, I can tell you, it was the most difficult part of the entire model so far. As you can see, I've made the other side as well. Very difficult, very time consuming, and here you can see almost is visible the joint. I can tell you that this part will all be painted black and the wires will be painted gold like these pieces here. Now, before proceeding to this step over here, I must open a couple of holes for the anchors. As you can see, I have marked where to open the holes. It's the third plank and between the fourth and fifth plank. I'm not sure that the 4th, 5th is visible on camera because it's sanded down, so probably it won't be visible as the live view. Let me place the camera on tripod and get started. So guys, according to the plans, I need to open 2mm holes. Let me remove the camera a little bit further because where the camera is going to be the drill. Sorry guys for that. So, let me open a couple of more at the other side and I'll get back to you to do the top. So guys, these are the materials. As you can see, I have to make two gratings. They must be with 13, and I call it's part of this extension with I call them ears. So I need 13 ears. As you can see, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So I must cut 3 from each piece. I'm going to cut 2 from one side and 1 from the other, just to make every piece even, because if you notice carefully, you will see that the edges are a bit larger than the center piece in some, like here. So let me cut all of this into the appropriate length and I'll get back to you. Now guys, let's assemble the first one. First, I have to make the frame. So, let me glue it. How to glue? Sinoclear glue only. Start from the outside. Of course, you have to have a tube that lets the glue flow. And to every joint, just a small drop. Now, we have to glue also the inside parts. So, I let the glue dry for a moment and we will proceed with sanding. Alright now, let me readjust the camera because now we have to do a lot of cutting to make it match the bow, and I'll get back to you. So guys, what I see is that the gratings must reach up to this piece and also up to this piece. It's a bit tricky, so let me find out how to cut them and I'll get back to you because this will take a while. So guys, let me show you how I proceed. First of all, I cut off all the excess at the top because this grating must be inside this piece and up to this piece like it is now, but further down. So first of all, I got rid of this excess. Secondly, I got rid of this excess, and third, I made a cut here so this piece will be able to fit. Then here I'm going to cut it in the curve of the bow, but not just yet. As you can see, I've cut off this excess piece pieces so that I will be able to fit it, so I can take some measurements. So now I'm going to take some measurements to cut off all the entire part here, and then I will be able to fit it its proper position and cut off this part here according to the bow. And of course, as you can realize, that the second piece will be a match of the first one, so it will be much, much easier. So let me proceed to that and I'll get back to you. Now, as you can see, I have the first piece. All I have to do now is mark where the line of the bow is, cut, and it's done. Let me do that and I'll get back to you. And that's one piece, guys. Now, all I have to do is make another one exactly same as this one, because I have measured it, I have turned it around, and it's a perfect fit. So, no need to make again any marks. I have this piece for reference. Let me do that and I'll get back to you to show you the finishing result. And I have it, guys. I also had to add a piece here at the center. As you can see, the bow looks absolutely magnificent. So, let me get ready to place some rails and I'll get back to you. Now guys, it's time to place these rails. It's the part that I skipped before. So here I have a schematic. It's in scale, it's 1 to 3, so everything I measure must be by 3. So let me do some measurement and I'll get back to you. Now guys, I have placed some marks. You can see some percent marks where I need to place the rails, and I need to cut 24 of this 5x5 wood piece. So let me cut them and I'll get back to you. So I have cut 24 pieces, but before proceeding I must make sure that each surface is flat. Easy to do so. Of course, I have sanded down the entire piece before cutting, the entire wood strip, because now you can understand it will be impossible to sand down all these pieces. Now let me see how I must shape them, and I'll get back to you to make a couple. So guys, I have one, as you can see. So the procedure is not difficult, just time consuming, because I have to make 24 of them. So let's make a couple of them together. The tool that I use, this is a gift from my friend Jeff. Jeff, thank you very much. I wasn't able to find anything in Greece like this or in Europe, so Jeff was kind enough to send me one. Thank you again, Jeff. As you can see, it's flat, so I won't damage the surface of the wood. Just around file, above the center. Now, to make the upper part. Here it is. So, let me make all the others, 22 of them. Definitely, it's going to take some time. Wolf is going to make them. I'm just going to watch. Okay, Wolf, get work. Wolf? So, let me make them, guys, and I'll get back to you. Almost there, guys. But let me give you a small tip. Up to these rails are going to be tied a lot of ropes. I'm pretty sure of that because I'm seeing the picture of the completed ship. The ropes will have strengths that will try to unglue and pop out from its place. Every piece. So this is a tip that I use, this is a method that I use. I'm not only gluing the pieces, I'm also nailing them down. So here are some nails. Here is a drill tip of 0.8 millimeters, and I'm going to open a small hole right at the center. I'm inserting a nail. It's perfect. So before inserting the nail, just some glue. And the nail. Leave it dry. Up to the next one. So let me do all of them and I'll get back to you. Now guys, time to place them. But before, I have to cut each and every one to make them like this. So, just some glue here. And the piece is set. So you get the idea. Let me do them all and I'll get back to you to show you the finishing result. And done, guys. As you can see, she looks amazing. It's going to be the second best ship that I ever made. So, guys, thank you very much for watching. Join me to the next video where I'm going to make a lot of gratings on the deck. Now it's getting interesting. Very interesting. So thanks again. See you soon.